Module 1.3, first hour, third module. In this module, we will see different types of gates. We have already seen the NOT gate and the NAND gate. Now, we will see a set of gates. One is called AND gate, another is the OR gate, we will also see XOR gate and NOR gate. These are basically we will represent every gate by its what we call as the truth table. All of them are binary gates to start with. So, we will be describing their behavior using the truth table. So, A and B are input and out is the output for each of these gates. So, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, the AND gate is like this, OR gate is like this, XOR gate is, the NOR gate. Sorry, OR gate is 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay. So, these are all the 4 basic gates. We have already seen 2 more gates in the previous module, namely the NAND gate and the NOT gate. So, the AND gate is represented like this. The OR gate is represented like this, the XOR gate like this, the NOR gate is represented like this. The NOR is nothing but the OR gate representation followed by a small circle in front. Now, how are these gates related? Now, let us just quickly revisit back how NAND gate was defined. NAND gate was defined by and the NOT gate, which had a single input and output, was defined as 0, 1, 1, 0. Now, you can easily check that the AND function is nothing but the NAND function followed by a NOT gate. So, how do you verify this? Very quickly, we can see. If you take the outputs 1, 1, 1, 1, 0 for a given inputs and you invert them, so this 1, 1, 1, 0 will become 0, 0, 0, 1 and that is exactly the output of the AND gate, correct? And similarly, right, so the NAND gate basically can be expressed like this. Now, you can also see that the OR gate is nothing but out. So both these functionalities are same. For example, that OR gate is this. How do we get this? The OR gate is nothing but if you, let us just check one or two. Let us say 0, 0, this will be 1, 1, and 1, 1 of NAND is what? 0. So 0, 0, I get 0. Similarly, let us say 0, 1, this will be 1 and this will be 0. 1 of 0 NAND, 1 of 0, 1 0 NAND, as you see here, 1 0 NAND is 1. So I get this 1. Similarly, I can check for 1 0, it will be the same. Now let us check for 1 1. I get 0 0 and this is 1. So I get 1. Right. So that NOR gate can again be represented as the NAND gate and NOT gate. Now what is the OR gate can be represented as a combination of NOT gate and NAND gate. AND gate can be represented as a combination of NAND gate and NOT gate. Now NOR gate is nothing but OR gate followed by a NOT. Both are same, right. So if you take 0, 1, 1, 1, this is the OR gate output, and when you invert it, give it through a inverter as you see here, this will, this 0, 1, 1, 1 will become 1, 0, 0, 0 for the NOR gate as you see here. So and since OR gate can be represented as a combination of NOT and NAND, the NOR gate itself can be now represented as a combination of NOT and NAND, right. So if you just replace this OR gate with this, right, you get basically NOT and NAND representation of NOR gate. So what we have seen here is your AND gate, your OR gate and NOR gate, all of them can be represented using NAND gate, comma NOT gate. Right. We will talk about the XOR gate slightly later, but XOR gate is the same as OR gate except that 1 1 will be 0 rather than 1 1 will be 1. In the case of OR gate 1 1 is 1, while in the case of XOR gate 1 1 is 0. Right. Right. Now we will see something much. So what we have slowly coming out is all these basic gates, namely AND, OR and NOR, can be represented using NAND and NOT. Now let us take this one. Now let us see, suppose I connect to both the input of a NAND gate the same A, what will be the output? So we know that AB is out, 0 0 is 1, 0 1 is 1, 1 0 is 1, 1 1 is 0. This is what the NAND gate, this is how the NAND gate behaves, this is a truth table of the NAND gate. Now if I connect both the inputs to the same line, that means only 2 of these 4 inputs are exercised, this and this. Because since both the inputs are connected to the same line A, the second and the third will not be exercised. So essentially this B also becomes A. So now when you see this table, when I apply A, the out, when I apply 0 to A, what I get is 1, and when I apply 1 to A, I get 0. Now what is this? This is nothing but the truth table of NOT gate. So now you see OR AND and NOR can be represented using NAND, comma NOT. Now, NOT itself can be represented as NAND. So, NAND can represent all the four other gates, namely OR, NOT and then NOR, right. So, NAND is, we call it as an universal gate. So, NAND we call it as a universal gate, right. That is why this course is also called NAND to Tetris. Universal gate means anything can be built using the NAND gate, right. Now, we will come to the last part of this particular module, which is the XOR gate. XOR gate is built like this, right, that as we had seen earlier, 0 0 is 0, 0 1 is 1, 1 0 is 1, 1 1 is 0. So, we can basically build this as these are all NAND gates. So, let this be A B. Right. So, this is A B and this is XOR function. So, suppose I apply 0 0 here, by the NAND gate this becomes 1, this becomes 1 because this is 0, 0 1 is 1, for this NAND gate 0 1 is 1, 1 1 is 0. So, when I apply 0 0 I get 0. When I apply 0 1, 0 1 this is 1, 1 1 this becomes 0, 0 1 this is 1, this is correct, 1 0 becomes 1. So, 0 1 is 1. Similarly, 1 0 can be shown as 1. Suppose I put 1 1, this becomes 0, since this is 0, this is 1 and this is also 1. Both of them are 1 and 1 1 again becomes 0. So, the XOR gate that we described can also be built using NAND gates, right. So, the NAND gate can now build, what are the gates? It can build an XOR gate. Using NAND gates, I can build an XOR gate, I can build AND gate, OR gate, NOR gate and the NOT gate itself, inverter. So, every gate that we have seen so far can be basically built using NAND gate, and that is why NAND gate is called an universal gate, and we will and this course basically tries to use a NAND gate to build the entire computer on which we are going to execute the Tetris game. So, that is how the name NAND to Tetris has come up.